Welcome back. We're going to our second portion of our program. Mm-hmm. And we were talking earlier about the Common Core standards. Mm-hmm. And at this time, we're going to give Secretary of Education, Mr. Murphy, an opportunity to expound on that, particularly to our viewing audience, mm-hmm. particularly our parents.
Mm-hmm. Right, because we know about the testing. Parents are aware of young people going in and taking tests, and they're used to hearing DCAS.
Yes.
And DSTP, DCAS, and now we hear the Common Core state standards. So could you please shed some light on the Common Core state standards and why the move and the push, you know, why is it necessary and what it's about, a little bit about.
So when people ask me, what are the Common Core standards? You know, what are you talking about? You know, an average parent doesn't know what the Common Core standards are, or maybe has heard a little bit about it from their child or maybe from their teacher, but most people don't know yet what they are. And the simplest way to talk about them is that they are the things that our children should know and be able to do at each grade level. But there are some critical aspects about the Common Core that are different than other standards that we have used in the past couple of decades. One of them is that the Common Core standards started by naming what do our children need to know and be able to do at 12th grade so that they are ready to take that next step successfully. Right? So they took reading, they took math, they took writing, and they said, what does it look like for a 12th grader? Let's start there. To our vision that all of our children graduate ready for college and careers. Then they back mapped it. They said, well then what does it look like at 11th grade and 10th grade and right on down the grades. And so the Common Core standards are available to all of our parents. They're online, they're in all of our schools, and they clearly state what a child needs to know and be able to do. That's the first really important point. Another important point, and to your comment before about so much of what we do lands in the plate of a teacher, that our policies, our practices, the paperwork, mm-hmm. all of this lands in the plate of the teacher. And if you'll allow me to sidestep for 1 second, we just released a large data set from a survey that we did all around the state of Delaware. The survey is called Tell Delaware. So anyone right now can go online to Tell Delaware and see the results of the survey. And the results of the survey from teachers were what's going well and what needs to improve. And that data is available to everyone. Well, one of the things that they told us was that overall things are very positive, and they are happy to have to be working as a teacher. They're happy with their schools. Many positives, but there were a number of areas that we need to grow from. And one of them, to your point, was about how many things are on the plate, how much teachers are asked to do. So back to the Common Core. In the last couple of decades, most of the academic standards, this stuff of what kids need to know and be able to do, most of those standards have been many. That the average teacher might get a set of standards at the beginning of the school year that has 50 or 60 standards in it. Right? Too many to move through and to make sure that students have proficiency in those standards. What we have seen with the Common Core is that they are fewer, they are clearer, and they are more rigorous. Mm-hmm. To the point of saying, what does a child need to know and be able to do at this grade level to make sure that they're on track to graduate from high school ready for college and careers?
Yes.
Right? And let's name those things concisely, let's name them clearly, so that our teachers and our administrators and our districts have a clear roadmap. And to your point about parents, that our parents can see this, can touch this, can help their students through these standards. So that's what's going on right now. That's what's different about the standards. And we are in the middle of the implementation phase. So to your point, when you retired a few years ago, many of these initiatives and policies were just starting. We had just adopted Common Core, for example, and some of the early phases of implementation or even understanding what these are were happening. And what we are seeing now is that educators all around the state in all of our schools are working towards implementing their curriculum, their pedagogy, the teaching, their assessments that they do on a Tuesday morning, that they're lining all these things up to the Common Core standards. And they're in the middle of that implementation effort. We could talk 2 hours about this one, but one more anecdote about this. We have just launched as a state an effort called Common Ground. And Common Ground is where we are bringing educators from schools, not just district leadership, from schools. We're bringing them together to work together as school-based teams to implement the Common Core. But not only just as a school-based team, but across school lines and across districts, so that they're working together, right, across buildings. Mm-hmm. A few weeks ago, we had our opening event for Common Ground. We had over 700 educators come together, all together in one room, by the way, quite a sea of people. 700 educators come together on a Saturday. They chose to spend their Saturday working together in school-based teams to help implement the Common Core in their school, help to lead that implementation. 143 schools represented to work together to implement the Common Core. And that was an effort that we took on to help them implement the work that they're already engaged in. And over the next 18 months, we'll support them in that work as a state, right? Even though they're already doing the work. This is our attempt to help them implement even better.
And that's good, because that support is needed, as I had noted before. Mm-hmm. So now we have an understanding of the Common Core. One other point, too, that if, and you correct me if I'm wrong, if I have a child and I'm living, say, in Atlanta, and I move to Delaware, is the curriculum going to be different, or does the Common Core address that or help with that in that, you know,
Great
element?
Question. Great question, and a very appropriate question for where we live, right? Because there are so many states that are around us, and so many parents might not know that the standards, what students should know and be able to do, have been different in each of the states in the past. So each state set their own standards. One of the significant differences with Common Core is that they have been adopted by many of our states. Okay. And so now if a student moves from one state to another, they will have the same standards, right? Now, there is a difference though, and that is that how they're taught those standards is a locally based decision. And that's incredibly important. The Common Core is not a common curriculum. Mm-hmm. It's not every kid reading the same book on Tuesday morning. Okay. It is not everybody teaching like robots in the same way. No, we would never want that. Common Core sets out what our students need to know and be able to do. How they get there is determined by our teachers and our principals and our district leaders. Right? That's the curricular piece, the teaching piece. And so, yes, the student will have the same expectations, but the how is different. And think about that. It's so, many of the examples that I've seen over the years used by kids or by parents are the examples around like fourth, fifth grade. I hear this one used a lot. Well, I moved to another state and they were teaching fractions in fifth grade, but they were just starting. But the state I was in, we spent all of our fourth grade year working on fractions. So now I already know all this, and I'm sitting in this fifth grade classroom because my parents moved to a new state, and I learned all this. But maybe I missed some other things the year before. Maybe I missed some geometry the year before that now I'm not going to be taught in fifth grade because I'm in that new state. So now that child winds up with holes in their learning trajectory. Mm-hmm. Right? The Common Core, because our states have chosen to adopt it, many of our states have chosen to adopt it, it allows for more commonality in the expectations for our children.
All right, that's very good.
Very good. So I just want to ask, I know there's a push towards this early childhood education.
Yes.
And then I want you to touch upon that a little bit, and then tell about middle school, because the middle school focus, and I was a high school teacher, and so when we get those middle school students, we often had questions as to what has been happening with these middle school students. So could you please address from as Secretary of Education, push for early childhood, and then all school to middle school?
Middle school.
Sure. You know, my son said to me last night, he's thinking about being a teacher, and he said, "I am never going back to middle school." Yeah, those are often our most challenging years for our children.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And you know, in the education circles, sometimes people joke about middle school teachers that they are a special and rare group of people who love to nurture our children during those incredibly, sometimes incredibly challenging years.